Ready to wow your guests before the party even starts? Well, let me show you how to create an invitation maker here on JotForm. So follow me to my desktop right now. Welcome to JotForm. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to create an invitation maker. That means that by filling out a form, we'll automatically create a PDF that's an invitation that's pre-filled with the data that you just filled out. That means that you won't need an image designer to start designing manually each one of these invitations. It's gonna take way less time to do it here on JotForm. So let's get started. Now to get started, there's several ways to do this. We can start off with a free online editor. That means that we can try the PDF editor by setting up right here, or we can upload a PDF of an invitation and then assign the fields that we want to replace with our form. And the third method is to do it with a template, which would be one of the easiest way. So if we go to templates, go to PDF templates, we'll be able to find several templates that we can start using. Now, in this case, we want to find invitations. Okay, so let's search for invitation, and we'll be able to find several invitations that we can start using. Now we can go ahead and preview the invitation before we actually use it. So that means that in this case, we're able to preview how this is going to work. Now, this is a PDF of an invitation letter, and it already has elements that are going to be pre-filled out when we fill out the form. We can go ahead and see another one. For example, here's a new example. And this means that we have a PDF preview and we have a form preview. So this form will be tied to this PDF and it'll automatically fill in the spaces. Now in this case, I'm going to use this wedding invitation for our demo, okay? So let's go ahead and preview the PDF right here, form preview. And if we like what we're looking for, let's go ahead and use the template and get started. Now, the first thing that it's going to ask you is if you want to create a brand new form for this invitation, or do we want to use a form that we've previously created? In this case, I would recommend that you create a brand new form, and it will automatically populate that form builder with the elements that we're going to need for our invitation. And the first thing it's going to ask us is, do we want to get started by pre-filling out this form or doing it manually? So in this case, let's go ahead and fill out the form. And that means that by filling out this right now, it's going to update the demo data that we have right now. That way we have a sense of how it's going to work. So let me fill this out really quickly and get back to you. Okay, here we go. It is now filled out. I'm going to submit and the data will update on my invitation. So let me go ahead and close this. And here we go. We now have the new invitation, which is my name and my wife's name and the image that I updated right now. So it's now an updated look of this invitation form. Now, we're able to modify every single aspect of this, including the details that will be updated in each one of the forms that's filled out. Now, in this case, I can add elements, like basic elements, to the look and style of the invitation, which would be fixed things that I would add. So these are elements that are fixed that won't be updated with the form. And I will show you how to update with the form in a bit, right? So if I want to add, for example, an image, I am able to do so. So for example, this image that I'm adding right now will be a fixed image. This will not be tied to the form. Now I'm able to drag this and add it to different sections if I want. And as I mentioned before, these won't be updated with the form. Now, if I want to create elements that will be updatable with the details that I add, that will be in our form editor. Now let's go ahead and do that first before we jump into the next step. So let's go into the options on the top, go to form builder. And in this case, we have the form that's tied to our invitation. So all these elements that are filled out right here will be updated on the invitation. But if I want to add more elements, that is possible by clicking on elements, and there's several available elements that we can use for our form. For example, if I want to add a drop down for this, in this case, I'm going to say yes, no, and maybe. And these are just something that we can select that's going to be easy to add to our invitation, okay? So here we go, we've just added that element. Let's go back into our PDF editor and there will be a new element that we're able to use here on the invitation, and it's letting us know right here. So yes, proceed with the update, and here it is. So for example, let me go ahead and size this down a bit. Here we go, let's go ahead and drag it over here to the top. And here it is, let's go ahead and drag this to the bottom again. And here we go. So now we have this brand new element that will be updated once it's filled out. That's the way that you can add more elements into the invitation. In this case, I don't want to use this. It's just for testing purposes. But those form fields will be available here on the tab on the left. So for example, the type of question is the one that I've added right now, which would be an element that I would find when I fill out the form, and that will be added into this invitation. So it's pretty cool. It's super easy to make elements that are going to be new in your invitation. And once you're good to go, we're able to modify the look and style of our invitation by going into the PDF designer, and we can change, for example, the portrait, landscape, change the sizing, the background image. Do you want to use the default margin settings, or do we want to modify them? Show margin guide, show the page numbers, the element and style, for example, the font. So if I want to change the font to maybe something a little bit more classic, maybe something adding like a bitter, which would be a little bit more classic, we can change the color. So maybe we don't want to use the black. We want to go a little bit with a purplish, a little bit more purple. Here we go. But we get an idea of how this is going to display on the form. Now, that doesn't look really good, but just to give you an idea that it's super easy to modify the look and aspect of the invitation, including changing the answer styles, the font size, and that's for the answers, and the other ones are for the question styles. So question and the answer styles will be separated, so you can modify those differently, all right? And once you're good to go, we're able to send out these invitations. So for example, if I want this one that was just filled out, I can go ahead and send it out via the link or via an email. So let's go ahead and view the link right now. And that's going to generate a PDF for us. So that invitation is going to turn into a nice looking PDF that I can go ahead and download right now. So let's get a few seconds. And here it is. So here we go. We have the invitation here, and I can go ahead and download it. So it's pretty easy and useful to create invitations with the form here on JotForm and generate these automatically, either manually or do them via a CSV. Now, in this case, we're good to go. Let's go into the form section of this, so you can understand the elements that are tied to that invitation. So in this case, as you saw before, I'm able to add elements, I'm able to modify them, and I'm also able to remove elements if I'm not going to need them. So in this case, I dragged in a template, and in this case, the template brought in some elements that I might not need. Maybe the wedding time doesn't need to be here. Maybe that's just too precise. I can just go ahead and remove this, and that would be removed on the invitation. So that text for the wedding time won't be added into the invitation. Now, if I want to set an autoresponder for this form that's filled out to generate the PDF invite for the wedding, I can go into settings, go to email, and in email, I can add an email. So there's notification email where I can create notifications when someone fills this out in case it's not me. And I can do also an autoresponder email sent out to the email that's going to be tied to that one. For example, in this case, this form doesn't have an email, and I can add the email to this form that's built out. Here we go for this template, but I don't want that element to appear in the invitation. So in this case, I won't add that element. It'll just be on the form. So when I go to settings, go to emails, and I create one of the autoresponder emails, I can have that element to be used here. So in this case, I go ahead and remove it from the actual email inside, but I can use it for the recipients. The recipients will be tied to the email element. That way, it will be sent out directly to the email that you designate. So it's a really great way to send out the invitation right away when you create them. So in this case, I'm going to discard this. This is just for testing purposes, but it gives you an idea how flexible it is to create your invitations here on JotForm. Now, you're also able to view every single one of the invitations that have been sent out through JotForm tables. To view that, we're going to go into the top menu here, and we are going to go into tables. So each time that this is filled out, we are going to have a new row here with the details. And we're going to be able to view these in each single one of the rows that are created each time that the invitation is created. And we're going to have every single detail available here, like the passport ID, the partners, the wedding date, the wedding time, wedding location, the picture, and the email. In this case, this element is a brand new one that I've added after it was filled out. That's why it's empty right now. But we'll have all those details available for us to start viewing here on tables. Now, tables comes with different type of views, which are super useful. And in this case, I'm going to create a new tab, and I would highly recommend that you create a cards table. That way you'll be able to view each one of the invitations super easily. So in this case, I'm going to connect to this form, hit next, and it's going to be tied to this one, the passport wedding invitation. Let's hit next. And then we decide what we want to view on that card form. So it's like a resum of the details. So for example, I want to view the details for the partners, and I want to view the wedding date and the email. That's all I want to know. So it's just an idea of how you can create this, and maybe even the image so you can preview this super easily. But in this case, I'm just going to create the card really easily. So now I'm able to view each one of the submissions via card view. but with the summary of the details. So in this case, I just want to know who the partners are, when the wedding is, and their email. And these cards are going to be super easy for me to view. And I have the option to just go to the view every single table here with rows, or I'm able to go to the card view. And I'm able also to create different type of views depending on my needs. I can also create more card views with different type of details that I might want to view sometimes. And that's how easy it is to view here on JotForm. So you can see how easy it is to create your invitations here on JotForm using the PDF Maker. The idea is to not have to deal with designing each one of these invitations individually by typing each single piece of the text and dragging and dropping where you need it in an image designer. In this case, this will take care of everything automatically by just filling out the form, and it's going to add it in the correct spots of your invitation, and you'll be good to go to send them off right away, super easily. Plus, with the benefit of having JotForm tables to view each one of these invitations that were created, and the benefit of having a super customizable platform that's going to scale with your needs for your invitations. So definitely sign up for JotForm right now and be ready to wow your guests with a customized invitation that's going to be ready in a snap. So there you go. Sign up right now and we're good to go.